wake up, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. When I go out, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. If I get drunk, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. And if I haver, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's havering to you. But I would walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more. If I meet a man who walks 1,000 miles, then fall down at your door. But I'm working, yes, I know I'm gonna be the man who's working.
Eureka! Beadle, get down here. I've had a breakthrough, and bring your assistants, Zebarth and Ciri. It's gonna be a late night.
Glad to be on the job.
Glad to have you. Jay Ciri? Alright, I've heard marvelous things. Alright, Tatum, here's the thing. I've discovered the proper mold. The problem is, we don't know the enzyme relationship.
Let's get to work then.
Alright, Zebarth, Ciri, get in
here!
Time to get to work.
Cure for cancer!
cut all outside research. We gotta get our bread ball stuff in here.
Zebarth, get this down.
Sure thing, boss.
Zebarth, address this letter to the National Institute of Genealogy.
We have discovered through research, which will be later explained, that one gene codes for one enzyme. Now we have confirmed that indeed genes direct the manufacture of proteins that control basic metabolic functions. My associate will now explain the science behind the project.
We needed a simple life form for our experiment, and you see, new spore crassum mold was an ideal one for this, due to the fact that it only has one set of chromosomes. This allows the mutations to be expressed more easily. Our experiments consisted of us crossing irradiated new spore crassum mold that had been affected by mutations with non-irradiated new spore crassum mold. And this led us to discover that the offspring would not replicate without the enzyme arginine. So therefore, one gene codes for one enzyme.
Action!
Were we watching all this stuff?
Let's bring stuff all the dye.
Oh, geez.
Ben Nelson, seeing as I am a very, very, very critically acclaimed movie critic, if I were working for Rotten Tomato, this film would for sure be upper 80s. Upper 80%. No doubt. You can bet your bottom dollar.
Okay. All right, thank you, Isaiah. What the heck is Rotten Tomatoes?
So, right where they grade movies.
Okay.
Oh, it's okay. All right. Glad to have you. Jet Siri, right?
Yes.
Okay, sweet.
Okay, that's bad.
All right, well, let's get to work.
All right.
Tatum, Siri, get over here.
I'm Tatum.
I've discovered the proper enzyme.
It's mold.
Okay.
Hey.
You can keep talking. You don't have to, like, do random stuff when I'm...
Yeah! Sam Philly here. You may remember me from Home Alone 18. Honey, I dropped the kids off a ladder. And in this short film called Tatum and Beatles Extraordinary Adventure, I play a character called M. Zebarth. He's a hockey player. Background information, he's a hockey player. He enjoys seeing Miss Hennin. That's all we got.
Mike?
What?
Who's your character?
Mike, quit looking at my wallet.
It's mine, you thief!
What a piece of moldy bread work.
Well, that's kind of our only piece of moldy bread.
Oh, we have a whole loaf of bread then.
Yeah, but we don't have any more green food coloring.
Oh, we don't? Oh, no. Dang it.
Ever had a cold cup of coffee?
Yes.
Pretty piss poor, right? This bad boy, you turn this sucker on, it warms it right up. No need for more coffee. No. Save money.
All right.
End transmission.